Yeah, back again looking at another Marvel Legends Fantastic Four Invisible Woman figure. She stands just under 6 inches tall and is part of the Walgreens exclusives, Human Torch, and eventually Thing, as well as Reed Richards. So we'll get a look at her in just a second. We get the Four logo on the back of the box, Marvel Legends, the logo up at the top. Some very nice artwork on the side, looking very cool there, actually. I do like that. And in the back, we also get Hervey, which we'll look at in just a second. So, pretty cool. She's got a kind of translucent arm and a swap-out hand, which we'll look at shortly. And it says there, with Hervey by her side, Sue Storm uses psionic energy to suit up as the incredible hero, Invisible Woman. On the bottom, there is some UPC and yada yada stuff for you if you want, and that's pretty much it. Now again, this figure is relatively easy to find. She's not been the difficult one to locate. It seems to be the Human Torch, and wait for it, the Thing when he comes. So first of all, let's go look at Hervey. He comes with a stand, which you poke up his butt. Little plastic kind of floaty stand, which is quite nice. Kind of smoky plastic would have been nicer if it was completely translucent, but I think that's apparently more expensive. Now, Hervey, if I remember, now let me know, someone who's watching, I can't recall, did Hervey turn up in a cartoon first, or was it in the comic first? I can't remember. Either way, pretty much a close rendition of Hervey here. We get a rocking kind of ball joint for his head there, so you can have him look inquisitively like a dog. And that's pretty much it. He doesn't really do anything else. These are kind of add-on pieces here, but they don't have any articulation or anything. No extra paint or nothing. Kind of looks like he's got a set of man boobs going on there. It's kind of like a little bit too flabby, Hervey. Get to the gym, boy. It's okay. You know, if you love Hervey, then let us know. If you want to pick this figure up, by the way, there's a link underneath to eBay and some other places. Hopefully you can grab it if you want it. So that's Hervey out of the way. Let's get a look at Sue. So she has a pretty nice facial sculpt, has to be said. Well, they've done a pretty fair job. Skin tone's a little bit too dark, and she seems to have a darker bottom lip than top, I think, which is intentional. But it's a pretty nice facial sculpt. We get some nice weathering on the hair, a little bit darker here and there. I don't recall seeing that hair before, so I think this is a new facial sculpt and hair. It's nicely done. We've got the Fantastic Four logo on the chest, although it's been poorly implemented. There's a big blob of black on there. C'est la vie. Rather cheap figure overall, and Hasbro know it. They have these kind of generic molds and bodies. I mean, again, it's just paint, the whole body, so it makes for a very, very cheap figure for them to do. So, yes, gigantic ass hole in her back, so no idea what figure she was from before in the past. Anyway, Reed Richards didn't have one, so I'm not sure why she had one. Anyway, there you go. If anybody knows why she's got a gigantic hole in her back, let me know. I know a lot of Marvel Legends figures have had them in the past for other things, backpacks and what have you, but female figure? Never seen that before, don't recall. Anyway, that's pretty much what she's got. She's got a translucent plastic hand, which is kind of entirely translucent, and then it's been kind of spray painted down to this kind of black translucenty colour, so it's a little bit weird. I think I would have almost preferred it as solid translucent, because what we get is the joint showing up as a really weird kind of white part and the rest of the hand's black, so it's a little bit odd the way they do, but I get the idea that they're coming from. What they also give you is another kind of translucent-ish hand, just kind of semi there and know it, and just enter the cuff. Or if you really just can't be bothered, you just swap it out with a regular black solid plastic hand. Now, the thing to note about these, and I'll talk about it in a Fantastic Four Human Torch review, is this is very brittle plastic. It's not going to be too much of a problem on her because there are no real joins. It's such that the Human Torch already has a bicep swivel and a double joint at the elbow. She doesn't have much, so it's not really much of an issue, but we do get a nice pose on those fingers there, that kind of, anyway, it just looks good. And it's not a bad looking figure, but not a lot else going on with it. Anyway, in terms of articulation, you get some good movement on the head, ball jointed on a hinge, and she can go ridiculously far forward, but kind of nothing back the way because of the mullet going on there, so a little bit further back, but not quite as up as much as I would have liked. No real limitation at the shoulders, so pretty good all the way. Single joint, which is a bit sucky. If you look at the angle of articulation that she can move to, that's it. I mean, that's miserable. That's like a 30 degree. If I was a stormtrooper, I'd be so pissed. But it's not. But this arm does go up. So, not sure what's going on. Maybe if I turn around. I am an asshole. There you go. There you go. I take it back. But still, it's a 45 on the nose. So there you go. So, yes, I was an idiot. But there you go. Still not quite even 45. But anyway, you get the point. It's not too bad. She's got an upper chest swivel there. And reasonable-ish kind of movement. No waist articulation. Pins up at the top of the thighs. Thigh joint. Double joints at the knees. No boot cut. And rocking ankles and peckles for those things that we just don't really get from Marvel Legends ever. Good figure, though. Do like it. It's really kind of improved by, I think, the pose in the hands and the head sculpt. It's not too bad, but let down by the little blob of messy paint. And the quality of the blue and the plastic is pretty shoddy when next to Reed Richards' much, much darker blue overall. And just looks a bit odd why one is kind of lighter blue and one's darker blue. It's not really showing up in the camera too much, but it's quite noticeable. Anyway, there's the two of them together. Let us know what you think. If you like the video, give it a like. Give it a thumbs up. If you like the show that we do, the 6-inch show, or you like 6-inch figures in general, you can watch us on the 6-inch show. Matt and I from Instagram's Star Wars The Black Series talk Marvel Legends 6-inch figures of all kinds. Click subscribe and the little bell notification and you'll get it. That's it from me and the Fantastic Twosome. We'll see you for another review coming up.